mosque. So finally we have landed in Istanbul right now, and we took a 1 hour flight from Cappadocia to Istanbul, and this is just day one, and we are staying in one of the busiest street of Istanbul called Eskim Square. And as you guys can see, this place is pretty packed and full of tourists. And the reason is that because this is the only country which connects the Asia and Europe. So that's why tourists all around the world are over here, and plus the summers, you know. So definitely it makes sense. And we are all set to explore the city more. So do keep it locked. Cousin Burak's one of the restaurant in Tashkent Square. It's called Al Madina restaurant, and that's how it looks like. In the entrance he got all his images with the celebrities and famous people all around the world, and this is actually one of his oldest restaurant in Istanbul. Called Authentic, and it's located in the Eskim Square, and it's pretty famous because of this lady right over here. She's the one who actually cooks and serves each and every guest, and even their taste is pretty nice, and even they have a good range of variety in food also. So we will be just trying out their food, and let's see how it is. Hi guys, very good morning, and today is a day two, and we just got done with our breakfast in the hotel in Mr. Kass. It was pretty nice, literally breakfast with a view, and now we are just heading towards Gilara Tower, which is 10 to 15 minutes walk from the Eskim Square itself. So we are just heading over there, and it's just early in the morning, and still like this place is still happening. This right over here is the entry point to go inside Galata Towers, and they just go all the way to the top for the view of the whole city. So right behind me is Galata Tower, and this is the tower which was established on 29th of May 1453. And this place is actually famous because of the view, and they have an entry point so people actually go on the top and just enjoy the city view of Istanbul. And the entry fee for this one is 10 euros per person, but I think it's good if somebody wants to enjoy the view and see the skyline of the city. It's a perfect place to explore. Right now I'm sitting at the place called Hagia Sophia Grand Holy Mosque, and this place was actually the church once, and now it's been transformed into the mosque officially. And this place is quite famous in Istanbul, and people all around the world come over here just to see and just to get to know about the culture, just to know about the history. And this area is actually one of the most historical areas of Istanbul. We just got done now exploring Hagia Sophia Grand Mosque, and literally it was a really, really nice experience. Once you walk in, you see a very nice calligraphy all around the wall, and even the interior is pretty beautiful. Literally the beauty of this place cannot be described in words. And now talking a bit about the history of this place, before 1453 this place was actually considered as a church. It was actually the church, and then after that Sultan Ahmed, he's the one who conquered this as a mosque, and since then it has a status of a mosque only. One more interesting fact about this place is that from 1935 to 2020 this place was actually opened as a museum, but now the Turkish Republic have actually reopened this officially as a mosque also. So during the prayers time they actually have a proper azan over here, and people offer prayers as well, so it's pretty nice. And regards to the price, it's free of cost. There's not any specific cost to enter inside the mosque. And just a quick tip, if you guys are planning to come over here, you should dress appropriate because they will not let anybody go in. And also you should carry a headscarf, because without the headscarf they will not let you go in. Also, one more point I would like to share is that this place is actually famous because this is the only place where you will be able to see the Christianity culture and the Islamic culture all under the same dome. Sultan Ahmed Mosque, which is also known as Blue Mosque. Now the reason this mosque is called Blue Mosque is because it's all hand painted blue tiles, and that's the reason they have named it a Blue Mosque. Now we went inside the Blue Mosque, but it was all closed, it was all under construction, maybe because this place actually attracts large number of tourists every single day. That's why they're just constructing the whole place and whole mosque. So yeah, we were not able to like look around more, but maybe next time. Very famous restaurant called Nusrat, and we'll be trying their food over here in Istanbul. So super excited to try this one out. Yeah. right now, we just had an experience of trying out one of the very famous Turkish restaurant called Nusret the Salt Bay, and located in Istanbul. And that's his one of the very first branch in Istanbul. Before he got all famous over here, he opened his branch, and then he uploaded the videos of him sprinkling the salt and cutting the meat slices in a very stylish way, and all these videos went all viral, and he became the internet sensation, and he became famous all around the world. And then after that, he opened his now he has around 8 different branches in all around different countries. So he's a superstar now, like, you know, and people from all around the world actually come over here and try out his food. And even over here, like in Istanbul, it's pretty packed. Literally, even though we had the reservation, we still had to wait for 15-20 minutes more, because the queue outside was long, and even inside, like, each and every table is just super packed. And now regards to the food, I mean, if you are a meat lover, you need to try out this food. Like, you cannot miss this. The quality, the way they have maintained their quality, their style is just up to the mark, and would highly recommend if you guys are in Istanbul, do try out this restaurant, because this is actually one of his first, and even the interior is just so classy and nice. It's day 3 in Istanbul, and today we'll be exploring one of the largest museum in Istanbul, called the Topkapi Palace Museum. And this right behind me is the main entrance, and we just got our tickets now, and the line was like pretty long. Like, it literally took us around 45 minutes to get the tickets, and we'll be just going inside and exploring it more. And this is how the entrance looks like, and we have just got the audio translator as well, just to know like what all the areas are about and all the information as well. These all are the pans which they used to use for the cooking. You guys can see it's pretty huge, because they used to cook for around approximately 12,000 people per day. This right over there is the area where they used to hold all the private gatherings and meetings. This was the library of Sultan Ahmed. He was the one who have built this in 18th century, and he was a big fan of books, and he always used to take his guests to his library and show it to them. And as you can see, the library room is actually like pretty big, and it's not less than a room. Got done now exploring Topkapi Palace Museum, and this museum is actually pretty huge. You literally need around 3 to 4 hours to explore, and this museum is actually one of the only museum which have got all sort of Muslim history and culture put all together. And this place is basically about Sultan Ahmed's life, about his palace, how things used to work back in 15th and 18th century. Once you walk in, you see all sort of different courtyard, and you see like one area is dedicated only the kitchen area, because in that one they used to cook for around 12,000 members per day, and then when you go on the other side there, you see how they used to have like small areas, and they used to have meetings over there, they used to have different kind of get-togethers, festive seasons used to happen over there. And regards to the entry, they have charges around 20 euro per person, and the queue is also pretty long. Like if you're planning to visit over here, it's better to come early in the morning around 9 or 10.
Push again back. Been losing my mind, like being lost in you. Yeah, your blue eyes on my plans reversing. You know that it's working. You're working. Don't care, you're crazy, it's perfect. Shaky and I'm slurring.
Istanbul is a city of mosque. Literally, you will see mosque in every corner in the city. And talking about this place, this is the only city which connects two continents, Europe and Asia, through the very famous bridge called Bosporus Bridge. And now one more fact about this city is that this is the 15th largest city in the world. So you can imagine how big and huge this place must be. And talking about their people, they are so friendly, they are so nice, they are always ready to help, and they always have smile on their faces. So it was a really good experience altogether. And one more like a major factor which many people face when they're traveling is the food. Like they don't get a really good food, and they don't know what to eat and all. But over here there's like unlimited options when it comes to food also. And regards to the experience in Istanbul, this place is actually one of the major tourist spots because of the various reasons. They have many things to do over here, many activities, many tourist attractions. Few of them, if I have to name, is the top one is the Skim Square, which is the whole street full of restaurants, cafes, brands, shopping, entertainment. It's a really nice place to visit. And then the other one is the Blue Mosque and Hagia Sophia and the Tobaki Palace Museum. These all are located at one place. More than that, the city got a really nice culture vibe. Like you can see even the structure of this city is more like a European style and very vintage. And it's a really, really nice city to visit. With this note, it brings to an end of this amazing trip in Istanbul. And if you guys have any sort of questions, then please do comment below. And if you guys like this video, then don't forget to like, share, comment, and don't forget to hit the bell icon button to get all sort of notifications. And we will be back with another amazing video. Till then, bye.